What's up, guys? It's your favorite twins, and the time has come. Today, we are reacting to Dawn FM.
We read that the album sort of takes place in purgatory.
Yeah, like this purgatory state. And yeah. I'm not gonna lie, when you look at the album cover, so like you look at Genius. After Hours, yes. And then you look at Dawn FM, my man aged
a lot.
My man aged a lot. So I really like that sequencing. I like that concept. I like the storyline.
Continuity, is that the word?
Maybe it's continuity. Something that's pretty cool is that the 103 radio tag is like a nod to a Toronto yeah. radio station. So that's pretty cool. I like how artists, you know, kind of mix a little bit of home in there.
Yeah,
you know
what I mean? Makes it more unique and yeah. signature to them.
Yeah.
So when I think of purgatory, I think of being stuck. So yes. I'm wondering how he's gonna play with those themes.
And the sound.
Yeah, now yeah. some of the music that I've heard just out and about or scrolling, I've seen bits and pieces of the music videos. The music sounds different from After Hours. It sounds
very
more
different.
Disco-like.
But I think that fits the vibe, oddly
enough.
You think
it's gonna be darker in After Hours?
If it's not gonna be darker in sound, it's gonna be darker in meaning.
Hmm.
I don't know.
I wonder because it's in that in-between stage.
Exactly.
So you could be either headed towards something better,
or
something worse.
Something worse.
Huh.
Well, that sounds pretty. But almost like you are seeing the light.
Like you just woke up.
No, like you just died.
But I'm saying like you just died. And you just woke up.
Oh, just woke up in
a purgatory state.
Okay.
This part I do alone.
I like, I'm gonna try not to pause and talk so much, but that line I already like.
This part I do alone.
Because you have to go that part alone. Like,
yeah.
it's just you.
Yeah.
Why'd that hit so hard?
This part
I'm not even trying to be dramatic. That, like, that hit hard.
Especially after, like, Until I Bleed Out.
Yes.
The last song.
This is the part I do alone.
I like that. I like that.
Is that the first song? Alone again?
Whoa.
You are now listening to 103.5 Jim Carrey. FM. You've been in the dark for way too long. It's time to walk into the light and accept your fate with open arms. We'll be there to hold your hand and guide you through this painless transition. Just relax and enjoy another hour of commercial-free music on 103.5 Dawn FM. Stay tuned.
Two things.
Okay.
Free yourself. Oh, that was a little sinister.
Enjoy commercial-free yourself
yes.
music.
Yeah, that was a little sinister, though.
There's yes.
That was like a yes. little interruption, a little glitch in the system.
That was good. And it also having Jim Carrey.
That's iconic. And
103.5.
I like that little jingle. Oh, this is going to be something.
Going straight into Gasoline. That sounds good.
I'm not over that Free Yourself. That was really
that,
like,
that's clever.
That's once again showing that in between and the radio is kind of like giving you an illusion,
yes.
essentially. But underneath it is something much darker.
So much darker.
Like you have no idea where it's going to
come. Oh, that's good.
My time again. I've soaking up the moon. Can't sleep.
I like that.
Hear the difference in his voice?
Yeah.
I'm pushing myself further. I'm just trying to feel my heartbeat beat. It's 5 a.m. I'm high again. And you can see
oh, you hear that
I'm
back?
In pain.
His voice is also starting to return to normalcy.
I'm dozing off to RAM. I'm trying not to lose my faith.
It's my faith. That's my song.
Oh, yeah.
Still playing with those themes for
Just wrap my body in these sheets and pour out the gasoline. It's 5 a.m. I'm nihilist. I know there's nothing after this. Obsessing over aftermaths, apocalypse, and hopelessness.
Yeah, hopelessness, I was gonna say.
Around we go.
When he says pour out the gasoline, does that like imply set him on fire? Like,
I was trying to figure that out too.
Like, and then?
Okay, so it's 5 a.m.
Right.
So he's having these this battle,
right?
With inner thoughts.
Yeah. 5 a.m. also being like dawn, the time.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But also like fear of separation is kind of how I take this as well. Of like trying to hold on to one last good thing.
If I, so it's like the order. I know you won't let me OD. And if I finally die in peace, just wrap my body in these sheets. Like kind of like let me go feeling everything good that I, because if he died in peace, he's saying wrap me in these sheets basically that I've died in.
Yeah.
Because he's at peace in those sheets. And then pour out the gasoline, which would imply like.
So I had to read it because I wanted to make sure we were on the right track. Yeah, it is lighting the body.
Okay, that's what I thought. Like lighting the body and putting an end to him in that way.
Yeah.
So I like how we're once again playing with the thoughts. It's once again conflicting.
Yeah.
Can be confusing at times. But that's what purgatory is. So it plays really nicely into the theme. And then sonically, I don't know if it's like a, is it an 80s?
Yeah, it definitely has like an 80s
pop sound.
Jordan.
Yeah, that transition was sick.
That's because I looked at the time and I was like, we still have a minute left of the song. Like, what
where else is he going to go? Yeah.
But building up that anticipation for Take My Breath.
That was dope. I liked that.
That is good.
That was dope. How do I make you love me? What can I do?
What can I do? And that's definitely like bending over backwards, which is funny because like for Gasoline, he's kind of saying that like their relationship is the only good thing left in his life. So I feel like how do I make you love me kind of plays off on that and saying like I'm willing to do anything to have you stay with me.
It's almost like he's saying the only way to make you love me or for you to even remotely love me is to step into my world to understand. Like the first verse where he says, I'll fix you mushroom tea, obviously like shrooms, I would assume. More psychedelic drugs and that influence.
Yeah, I caught that.
And cross the restless sea. So, like, something they would experience together on that trip.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, it's like, if you were to step into my world and be under the same influence that I am.
To escape reality.
Maybe you'll, maybe you'll understand me more and in turn love me more. So, that's what I was getting to.
That's true.
Very, like, it keeps you in this sort of, this one state.
It's again, I think the
purpose that makes sense.
Is very psychedelic. It's
so... But it's keeping you in this one state so far, which I'm wondering if that's going to be consistent throughout the album. Because it is, I feel like that's on purpose.
Of course.
So that you as a listener can feel like you're in purgatory as well.
Exactly.
Let's see.
I like that.
See? Yeah. Feels like now we're getting started. Like,
yeah, right?
Hey.
Take my breath.
But this is, I think, playing into a little bit of a sexual.
Oh yeah, definitely. Essentially, that's his way of connecting.
But like, cause he says her fantasies, like they're okay with me. So yeah. It's like sexual.
Innuendos?
No, her sexual likings, like people that are like, you know, some people are into like knife play. Some people like stuff like, what do you call those?
Kinks.
Kinks.
Oh.
Sexual kinks.
Like kinks. Yeah.
So now she's saying, take my breath away. He's like, huh?
Huh, wait, we're going a little too far now.
Right. I like
I
that.
I see, bring me close to heaven, babe.
Exactly.
So, like, once, oh, again, living on that edge, which yes. is that darker undertone coming in.
Exactly.
See?
Exactly. But this is, again, it just goes to that psychedelic, like, you're just supposed to feel the music. You're supposed yeah. to take you somewhere.
It's supposed to put you in a trance, yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
Take my breath. Uh-huh. And then sacrifice
coming right after it.
And you think, and I, maybe that's why he says like he doesn't want to be the one to pay the price. That's like a sacrifice, like.
Right.
If I'm taking your breath, I'm, you know.
Like that, yeah. I think we kind of hit the meaning of the song, like, on the head.
Definitely. I think it's a double.
Right.
Sexual, like you were saying.
Yeah.
Like, take my breath away in that moment, like, you know.
Yeah.
Make it good.
Yeah, make it good.
But then also,
like,
body bag me.
They like to live life on the edge, but again, it kind of works because he's living life on the edge.
Exactly.
And so he kind of wanted to bring her into his world.
Because of the prior song.
Right.
Roping her into that.
Exactly.
Now she's like...
Now she's in it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like that.
Ooh, it up. Oh, this gave me a little Motown.
Yeah, right?
I was born in a city.
Snow Child.
Oh.
Throwback.
Haha.
So this life's always with me.
The yeah, because
inside
it
my veins will never bleed.
Oh, I like all those calls.
Ooh, that was nice. That's I got a little ahead, but that was nice.
That's good.
The ice inside my veins will never bleed.
Oh, my.
Every time you try to fix me.
Seamless, like listening
Sick.
To a radio station.
Sick.
Seamless.
Okay.
I didn't even realize it was about to end.
I was looking at the time, I said, it's gonna go into the next song. Oh, sick. Let me say this about Sacrifice. I love Take My Breath.
Right.
But I am mad that this was not the lead single.
Sacrifice?
I think this song is so good. Now, let me say this, though, as well. That meaning.
Mm-hmm.
I love my time with you.
Right.
But I battle that your love is worth sacrificing my lush life.
Yeah.
I don't want to sacrifice.
I don't want to.
I've tried. Like, he's saying, believe me, I have tried to give this up for you.
Right.
That's why he says, we can fuck like friends.
We can.
But don't catch feelings, though.
Yeah.
Because I'm not willing to give up what I do for your love.
But I'm not willing.
But no. I love my time with you, though. Like, don't get it confused. I don't want to sacrifice, but I do love my time.
Mm-hmm.
As in, I think that means, like, my time with you.
Don't drag me, y'all. But this song reminds me of Thriller.
Yes!
A little bit. Just a little bit.
And that's, you know what's funny?
It does.
I was listening and I was like, damn, this beat reminds me of something. Like,
Motown.
It makes me want to just,
that era, absolutely.
Yeah, it's that era for sure.
And I know we always get some Michael Jackson comparisons, but listen.
But
the influence is there. And you can hear it.
Yeah.
And I think this was a great song. This, like you said,
this
is a good single as well.
This is good.
So, and those callbacks to the other album, and just other songs.
How iconic that Quincy Jones comes in next after the most
talented influence.
That's insane.
Okay. So different. Oh, this is
Quincy's
real super.
Looking back now, I didn't know what it was supposed to be. And it's like raising kids, man. If you weren't raised, you don't know how to raise, you know? I will never forget watching my mother get put in a straitjacket and taken out of my home when I was only 7 years old. I later had an evil stepmother who further cemented the idea that I didn't need a mother. Whenever I got too close to the woman, I would cut her off. Part of that was vindictive and partially based on fear. But it was also totally subconscious. Looking back is a bitch, isn't it?
Oh, how flawless.
The way that connects, though.
Yeah. Because his issue,
Whenever I got too close to a woman, I would cut her off. Parallel sacrifice.
It does.
But also, it unpacks another layer of that fear.
Yes.
Yeah, I like that a lot.
So wait.
This affects him now as he doesn't know how to treat his current relationship right.
Exactly.
So they were able to draw both of their lives.
Yes.
That's nice.
That was nice.
Very, yeah.
Wow. I like that.
That adds such a personal layer.
Such a layer, yeah.
Love that.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm more of a Quincy feel.
Yes.
Yeah.
I just like the sampling.
Yes.
Because we just got done hearing from a legend from that era.
Yes.
And now we're continuing that vibe.
That vibe. The last few months I've been working on me, baby. There's so much trauma in my life. Remember when I held you?
Touch that dial, because like the song says, you are out of time. You're almost there, but don't panic. Little lights you see in the distance. Soon you'll be healed, forgiven, and refreshed, free from all trauma, pain, guilt, and shame. You may even forget your own name. But before you dwell in that house forever, here's 30 minutes of easy listening to some slow tracks on 103.5 Dawn FM.
Okay, because...
What?
Maybe I have another understanding now.
What's that?
Purgatory, I've heard like two different sort of beliefs. There's the purgatory in which heaven and hell.
Right.
It's between heaven and hell.
Right.
But I've also heard the purgatory in the sense of reincarnation, to where there is no heaven or hell, no better or worse. There's it's a just, redo. You do life again.
Maybe.
A second chance. That's why he says here, you'll be free from all the pain, the trauma, pain, guilt, and shame. You may even
forget your own name.
Exactly, because you're going to be a new person.
Makes sense.
But before you dwell in that house forever.
Here's 30 minutes of easy listening.
Maybe we're playing with both concepts, both we beliefs a little bit, and blending. Both concepts. Have we missed something?
I don't know.
Those are just my two understandings of purgatory.
That's so clever. I love that. That is very clever.
And I like that we tied Jim Carrey back in.
Into it, yes. It keeps
the consistency. I'm enjoying this.
I love this.
I'm enjoying this.
Consistency.
For yourself though, and free your soul. I feel like it's a flip of perspective.
Yeah.
You know what though?
It could be like.
What do you think? Because maybe we're thinking the same thing.
Free your soul. Maybe it's not always like. I'm thinking like free yourself of the things that also hold you back.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And allow yourself to be open to new things.
Absolutely.
So I see how this could be. Like how this works with. Here we go again. What were you going to say?
So, like, I agree with you. 100%. Like, that makes me think of when he was talking about trauma.
Right.
And things like that. Shame. Right. Freeing yourself from those things. So, we're definitely on that line.
Yeah.
But, I'm thinking about the context. Remember earlier in the album, it was free yourself.
Yeah.
And it was almost sketchy.
Yeah, it was almost like...
And a little sinister.
Yes.
A little scary.
Yeah.
Here, he's saying, free yourself, free your soul instead. Yeah. And it sounds more optimistic, and it sounds more positive.
Right.
Because now we're talking more about going toward the light. Right. And that whole conversation about purgatory and whether it's reincarnation or not.
Right.
Do you think it's said two different ways because death at first is scary?
Yes.
But then
some people find beauty within death.
Exactly. But also, like, that transition can be scary because you're leaving behind who you were. So you almost resist it.
Right.
But as you're moving through, because I saw that Abel said it's kind of like a, like sitting in traffic and being stuck.
Right.
As you're moving through the traffic, though, you're getting closer and closer to your destination. So while you're scared of what could happen along your way.
Eventually.
You can see that little light.
Yeah.
And Julian pointed out that light at the back. On the cover.
Yeah, that's in the cover. Yeah, it's on the cover.
So, I hope that made sense.
It does.
Because that's kind of like what my brain is. No, it feels like a journey of coming to the light.
Yes.
And perspective changing, and you're kind of embracing that light more and more.
Yeah.
Instead of resisting it.
Yeah.
I was also going to say, I had a lot to say, y'all. Y'all know I talk a lot.
No, it's not.
I like this one.
Yeah.
But I'm conflicted with whether or not I wanted a beat. I feel like if we got a beat, it would have either cheapened it
Or added to it
and made me like it more.
Yeah.
But I like sort of how contemporary it sounds.
It was very contemporary.
They both killed it.
They did.
That you gonna sign this prenup as that classic Tyler into there.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is another good addition to the album for sure.
Yeah.
I'm sitting back like an old man.
Yeah, 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 yeah. You wanted a beat.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, what we got, baby, what we got is secure in a pot of toxic love. It tore us apart. Things you want, you're my best friend now. Oh, I don't want to be responsible for your heart if we fall. You're my best.
What was that? He probably said we're gonna get into some slow jams, and we getting slow jams. Just continuity.
This shit hits.
That one hit.
Best friend, I actually feel like that song. Same. You wanted a beat, you got it.
I got my beat.
They've had sex as friends. Mm-hmm. So the fact that he is now cutting this off because he doesn't want to be responsible for her.
Right.
I cannot handle your fragile heart.
Right.
I will drop it and break it.
Mm-hmm.
So we best friends now.
He said.
Because we've already crossed that line.
Right, you can't be friends.
We can't be friends.
We can be best friends.
Because we've done things, but we can be best friends now.
Right, right.
I love that.
The connect.
It's funny because talking about best friends,
mm-hmm.
and now is there someone else?
Yeah.
It's almost like again another change of heart.
Mm-hmm.
I know I said that I lied. I wasn't ready to settle down, but then I think I lied again.
Right.
And it's like, okay, well, if there is someone else,
mm-hmm.
it definitely makes him feel some kind of way. It's like I, for some reason, I can't handle that. Although I said that I wasn't ready to entertain you and handle your heart.
Mm-hmm.
I also can't stomach to see you with somebody else. That's why, like, are you hurting him or are you hurting me?
Right. Do you think that back and forth is a side effect of the transition?
Could be.
He's healing. Mm. Through this transition, he's healing.
That's true.
He's leaving behind the trauma and the shame and the guilt.
Exactly.
So this is him owning up and saying, I'm ready to try this.
Exactly.
I don't know that it's my favorite cut, or even one of my favorite cuts. I'm not sure I care for it all that much.
Right. I feel you on that one.
I might have left it off.
Right. Like it,
but I feel the subject matter
is
important to the album.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
So it makes sense.
Yeah.
As to being here. But
all right, cool.
Wait, that started like immediately. I only met you in my dreams. Wow, that's so. When I was young and alone in the world, broken, hurting, suffering from the shattered soul.
Whoa.
Wow.
Let me be there. Let me be there for your heart. You were touched by a man so long. Cause I left. Let me be there for your heart. Let me love you like you need. And I'll make it my responsibility.
Responsibility. Wasn't he just talking about not wanting to be responsible?
Yeah. Then you can kick me.
I know what I said about Is There Someone Else? But Is There Someone Else and Starry Eyed Together is probably one of my favorite moments of the entire album. Like, it just, that's a good song. That's probably one of my favorites. I like that song a lot.
Yeah.
So I like how 10 sets up 11.
Right.
And then the way that Starry Eyed kind of, and the way that they connect, it honestly feels like one long song. Oh. Like they're meant to be together.
Yeah.
Also drawing from personal experience outside of relationships too.
Right.
It's like I think of Starry Eyed, obviously Starboy.
Yeah.
I like this one.
Yeah,
I like this one a lot.
This was cool.
Definitely, I'm seeing the gross.
Yes.
I feel that kind of feels like a continuation.
Yeah, right.
So great.
But you know what? It also feels like we've entered a new phase, though. Like that feels like the entrance to a brand new phase.
A brand new phase.
Like phase four.
Hmm.
Who, if I cried out, would hear me among the angels' order? For beauty is the terror we endure, while we stand in wonder, we are annihilated. Every angel is terrified. Intense, graphic, sexy. Euphoric,
sounds like a commercial.
Provocative, edgy, cinema like you've never seen it before. The exotic, bizarre, and beautiful world of Afterlife.
Sounds like an ad.
And this is your invitation to enter. The future of everyone's fate. Nigel and Frank call it a classic. Afterlife can be yours for only $4.95 with a subscription when you order the best of your current Life Collection series. A future out of control. And an experience you will never forget.
Don't say we didn't warn you.
Call 1-800-414-4444.
Android numbers. Yeah.
1-800-444-4444 now. To order
Afterlife.
Plus $3.79 shipping and handling.
Oh, wow.
That's gonna hit.
Is the next album called Afterlife? I feel like I saw that somewhere. Because this is definitely setting up to be somewhat of a trilogy.
Trilogy.
So if it, is the next one called Afterlife?
That'd be dope. This was a cool interlude.
It was. Leans very heavily on the theming. I like
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
I see you drowning in the purple lights. Now they're shining bright. I see empty eyes on you. You snatch my soul on crucified. Ecstasy. I keep coming back for more. I think that you would die for me. Destiny. Don't break my heart.
Oh.
Don't let me die. Please. Take it in. Another heartbreak, or I'll end it all. The girl I used to love, we broke up in the club. Now I know she wasn't right for me.
like that.
Don't break my heart.
I can definitely feel it winding down.
Yes.
I feel it.
I was going to say, I do feel it winding down.
Like, it's coming to enclose.
Coming to enclose, yeah.
To be or not to be a filler?
Definitely a filler. Definitely a filler.
Yeah,
like, I'm not totally there are sure. Definitely some aspects I like about the song. Pretty mm-hmm. self-explanatory when it right. comes to, like, the meaning and everything. I wouldn't say this one, like, is crazy deep.
Yeah.
But definitely a filler. Like, I don't hate it, but it's not one of my favorites,
yeah.
But I think, like you said, it's because it's winding down now.
Maybe kind of the way I feel about it is the same way I felt about Is There Someone Else a little bit.
But then who knows? I heard You're Married could really complement Don't Break My Heart.
It could. So, I do like that he's expanding on themes and topics we've already played with.
Yes.
Just to give more context. And sometimes it feels like a switch in perspective, like we said, as he's moving along this transition period.
Right.
So I do like that. But I'm interested in seeing how this album is going to come to a close.
Yeah, exactly.
Is it going to be repetitive? Or are we going to hear something a bit new?
Yeah.
Is something going to tie together?
I don't know.
TBA.
Can't be your private. I bet he treat you like Virgin Mary. You like it dirty and I'm dirty Harry. You put my love on the line and hang up on you. As a long kiss goodbye, I got a tongue to shoot. And my dogs cry, we ain't got enough to shoot.
I like that.
You walk down the aisle, I can make you run back. Like, fuck that. Tell hubby I'd kill him, no hubcap.
Whoa, whoa. I knew that this was too good.
You hear it way in the back?
Fade out.
Yeah, that's true, actually.
Okay. How do we feel about that one?
I would have cut.
Oh, shit.
You know why?
Why?
I feel like it's too late in the album. Not only have we kind of played with this subject before with Is There Someone Else? I feel like it's a situation where one or the other. And if it was going to be this one, it needed to be earlier on in the album.
I
feel like we're just coming to a close and it's like...
Yeah, I'm seeing that maybe towards the end we're kind of repeating topics.
Yeah.
And so I'm hoping Less Than Zero kind of brings us the feel that we felt at the beginning of the album.
Right.
I'm not saying that these songs are bad.
No, not that ever.
They just definitely feel like fillers.
Just a little bit underwhelming.
Maybe a little bit. But I do like that. I can't be with you.
That was nice.
I can't be with you.
I think I like Wayne on it. Just think maybe a different approach would have worked better for me. Not sure what it would have been yet.
Yeah.
But,
I don't know.
the song as a whole, I'm just like, the topic, like, it's not like, I don't know if he's drawing from personal experience. He could be.
I don't know.
Yeah, I just feel like we're coming to a close, and it's just one of them songs where it's like,
I get it.
Wow.
How do we feel about that one?
I love that one.
I like that one a lot.
Especially
actually.
As a closer. Yeah. What's interesting is I feel like we went around the sun just to end up back where we started.
I love that. I'll always be less than zero. Wow.
Which sucks to say.
Sucks to say that.
But
I think I can go for everything. I think that can go with his relationships. With his career, it's like, I try, I fall back down, I get back up, but at the end of the day, I can't shake this feeling that I'm just always going to be less than zero. I'm always going to be less than what you need.
I couldn't face you with my darkest truth of all, which is that this is who I am. It's kind of what I'm getting from it.
I just can't change.
It's what it is.
Yeah.
And I know that it's disappointing.
Yeah.
And so, like you said, in your eyes, I'll always be less than zero, but it's like... Maybe he's embracing that?
Yeah. I think so.
Like, to you, I'm less than zero, but I it's kind of corny to say, but I love me. Like, I'm happy with myself.
Yeah.
Being this way. Is that what you guys get, too? Because it could be speaking from the perspective of, I'm regretful because of that.
Yeah.
Or he's saying, I've done something to prove to you once again that I'll always be less than zero. And this is just my darkest truth, that who I... am or who I was is exactly who I still am.
Yeah.
And that whole period of me being your hero was me trying to be something that I'm not.
Yeah.
That's what it kind of feels like.
Very true.
You're tuned to Dawn FM, the middle of nowhere on your dial. So sit back and unpack. You may be here a while. And how many grudges did you take to your grave? When you weren't liked or followed, how did you behave? Were you ever in tune with the song Life Was Humming?
I love it.
If the pain's living on when your body's long gone and your phantom regret hasn't let it go yet, you may not have died in the way that you must. All specters are haunted by their own lack of trust.
Wow, I love this.
Heaven's for those who let go of regret. You have to wait here when you're not all there yet.
Perfect like that. Yes, oh my
God. You could be there by the end of this song. And if your broken heart's heavy when you step on the scale, you'll be lighter than air when they pull back the veil. God knows life is chaos, but he made one thing true. You gotta unwind your mind between your soul to a line. In other words,
that is so wow.
May peace be with you.
Right.
going out exactly when it came in.
Wow.
Phantom regret. Your ghost's regret, essentially.
Yeah. I loved that.
I did too. That totally
love that.
Captured the album in the perfect way.
Oh my god, I love that. You gotta be heaven to see heaven.
That's the whole point. Which goes back to what I was getting from Less Than Zero, which is being okay with yourself.
Right, but yeah.
You can't live with all that shame, guilt, and all of that.
You can't. Oh my gosh. And that's where The Weeknd was all of this album.
Yeah.
So if his album is called Afterlife, that makes sense.
Then that's where we're going.
Oh my god, that was so good.
Yeah, this was a great ending. Wow. Okay. Jim Carrey.
Yeah.
How fitting, too.
I know.
So, Don FM.
Don FM. What?
We did it.
We did it. I see why you guys were pushing for us to do this album. I mean, following the story of After Hours, this is just so well done. The attention to detail, the storyline, the lyricism, who he picked to do the intros, the interludes, everything. The way it was formatted to fit a radio station. It's just that is true artistry, in my opinion.
Yes, it is.
The first half of the album, so like tracks 1 through 9, right? Mm-hmm. They just put you in this like trance-like state.
They do, yeah.
And I think definitely that the first half of the album is some of my favorite songs. The back half, so 10 to 6 or 15, I should say, definitely slowed down a little bit. Mm-hmm. And I don't want it to be misconstrued that we didn't like that section. It just felt like a lot of fillers. And maybe it's because the first half of the album was a little bit more upbeat, but overall, wow, yeah, The Weeknd, this, I mean, and then when you look at the cover, I just feel like it just
it fits
the overall vibe and the aura of the whole album, so, this was good.
I really love the theming and the story all the way from the cover to the end of the album. It was consistent, it was cohesive, it was honest, and so yeah, I'm in agreement with you. And your thoughts about the album. I definitely enjoyed it. I do think I'm going to be getting this one on vinyl.
Oh, yes. Yes.
I think it's a great sequel to After Hours as well.
Yeah.
I am excited to see what's next.
Me too.
I like it as a sequel, but it almost feels like an extension. Because what I was going to say is, while I do like how the album begins and ends, that back half, there are some songs that I probably would have cut. Mm-hmm. I think that it could have been shorter because it is that purgatory. Because it got its message across pretty early in the album.
Yeah.
To where it kind of felt like it was dragging along a little bit toward the end for me. Mainly from like, we'll say like track 10 to 14.
Okay.
In between there,
yeah.
Maybe would have done some things differently, cut, shortened, whatever.
Yeah.
Really love how Less Than Zero took this out, as well as Phantom Regret.
Yeah.
It was just that little section for me where I was like, you got the point across.
Yeah.
Let's make it more
concise.
Concise would be the word. Let's make it more concise and shorten it. I would have done maybe 12 to 13. Maybe 10 to 12. I don't know, y'all. I like it because I like it as a piece in the middle of the trilogy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Almost like the bridge that's taking you to Afterlife. And an Afterlife could be 20 songs for all I care.
Right.
It's either to complement the theme of Purgatory because it feels like forever and you feel stuck. So maybe, like I said, that's on purpose.
I think it's on purpose, yeah.
But it's not a short journey. It's a long journey.
It's a long journey.
And I think you said that.
Yeah.
So I do get that aspect as well.
Yeah.
But just from a listener standpoint, I would have made it a little bit shorter. But other than that,
as always, we'd love to know what you guys thought about the album. Let us know your top 3 down below in the comments.
If you enjoyed watching us react, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications. That way you know when we upload. And we'll catch you guys on the next one.